Welcome to my presentation. My name is Joy Riungu, a PhD student from UNESCO IHE Delft. I am working under a Bill and Melinda Gates funded project within the theme of resource-oriented decentralized sanitation. For my fieldwork, I partner with Sani-BioR, which is a social enterprise working in Kenya. Sani-BioR fabricates urine diverting dehydrating toilets, that is UDDT, and sells them to slum entrepreneurs at a cost of about 450 euros. The role of Sani-BioR in these facilities is to ensure that the waste generated on a daily basis is collected from the individual facilities and transported to the central treatment point for Sani-BioR. Currently, Sani-BioR is using two main treatment options, that is composting and heating. However, due to the increasing amounts of UDDT waste which are being received by Sani-BioR on a day-to-day basis, they are exploring other ways of treating the waste. In this, they are looking at three main options. The first one is the black soldier fry. The second technology that is being looked at is the microwave technology. Then the third technology is the biogas project. Biogas is normally produced through the process of anaerobic digestion. Anaerobic digestion is mainly a fermentation process whereby organic matter is degraded in the absence of oxygen. Two main gases are normally produced during this process, which is methane and carbon dioxide gas. In my work, I am looking at optimizing gas production and also enhancing pathogen removal from UDDT feces. I am using two main substrates, which is UDDT waste and market organic waste. In order to carry out my work, I have divided it into two parts. One, laboratory scale batch test, and the second is pilot scale test. For the laboratory test, I had two objectives which I had to meet. The first objective was to assess biogas production and pathogen removal during digestion and co-digestion of UDDT waste and mixed organic market waste. The second objective was to evaluate the impact of volatile fatty acids, that is VFA, on pathogen removal from UDDT waste in digestion and co-digestion. In order to achieve this, batch scale experiments were conducted in 0.1 liter serum bottles with a working volume of 80 mL. Each bottle contained an average of 4 gram volatile acids per 100 mL of the waste sample. The experiments were conducted at 2 pH levels. In the first, the pH was adjusted to 4.8 using either 0.1 mHCl or sodium hydroxide solution. In the second case, the experiments were conducted at normal pH of the substrate. In these experiments, various UDDT waste is to mixed market waste ratios were used. These ratios included 4:1, 2:1, 1:1, 1:2, and 1:4, respectively. For each of these ratios, 4 serum bottles were set so that for each analysis of VFA, E. coli, and pH, 1 was sacrificed. In addition, 2 more serum bottles for each ratio were spiced with fertilized Ascalis lumblicoid X at a concentration of 200 X per mil in order to evaluate the efficiency of the treatment process in their deactivation. The bottles were then closed with rubber stoppers and argon gas flushed in order to create anaerobic conditions inside the bottles. They were then incubated at 35 degrees centigrade. For the different parameters that I have pinpointed in this work, different analytical methods were used. These parameters include volatile fatty acids, Escherichia coli, pH, temperature, Ascaris rumblicides, eggs. For VFA analysis, I used a stratification method from ARC, that is method 8196. This method has a range of total volatile fatty acids of 27 to 2800 milligrams per liter. The method is based on a stratification of the carboxylic acids present in the sample and subsequent determination of the esters by ferric hydroxamide reaction. The test results measure at 495 nanometers. Then the second parameter is Escherichia coli. In this test, the first thing also is dilution of the sample depending on the E. coli count in the sample. So in this, I used peptone buffered water for dilution. Depending on the sample that I was dealing with, I dealt with different dilutions. This sample used surface plating of the chromocoat coliform agar. The plates are prepared, and then about 0.1 ml of the diluted sample is plated, and this is surface plating. The plates are then incubated at 37 degrees centigrade for 24 hours. The third parameter is Ascaris lumblicide eggs. This I used a method developed by US EPA and later modified by scientists in South Africa. For all the eggs where a larval was observed inside the egg, these eggs were referred to as being viable. Otherwise, the eggs were referred to as being non-viable. The other parameter of interest was the total solids and the volatile solids. The analytical procedure followed gravimetric methods as outlined in the standard methods. The last parameter was pH. For the pH, I used a pH meter which was calibrated at standard solutions at pH 4 and pH 7. There were no major differences observed between the pH values obtained in substrates at both pH levels in co-digested substrate tested after the 4-day hydrolysis period. The results showed the ability of the hydrolysis process to lower pH levels enough for pathogen deactivation. Of interest was complete Ascaris egg deactivation within a period of less than 4 days in UDDTF is to market waste ratio of 1:4, 1:2, and 1:1 at both pH conditions. However, the VFA buildup was not proportional to the amount of market waste added in the UDDT sample, with optimal VFA accumulation being experienced at around a pH of 1:1. As such, from this objective and basing on the VFA accumulation trend, three particular ratios were particularly chosen for replication at field scale. These ratios were UDDT to market waste ratios of 4:1, 2:1, and 1:1. My reactors at Kinani are set up inside a greenhouse for temperature regulation. Using this setup, we seek to assess two objectives. The first one is to assess the impact of VFA accumulation on biogas production and pathogen deactivation in a two-stage pilot-scale anaerobic digestion and co-digestion of UDDT waste and organic substrates. The second one is to compare biogas production and pathogen deactivation in a two-stage and a one-stage anaerobic co-digestion of UDDT feces and mixed market organic waste. However, work on meeting these two specific objectives has not yet started. The ongoing work now is testing the hydrolysis reactor and comparing the results obtained with those obtained from the lab lottery scale. My hydrolysis reactor consists of a 45-liter container with a working volume of 30 liters. Three ratios are being assessed, that is UDDT waste is to mixed market organic waste at ratios of 4:1, 2:1, and 1:1. Preliminary results which have been obtained so far shows that a retention time of 4 days is adequate for Escherichia coli deactivation to WHO standards in less than 4 days, while the ratios 4:1 and 2:1 take greater than 6 days to achieve acceptable standards. The other thing that is happening now with digesters is stabilization. My digesters are plug flow digesters with a volume of 175 liters, a working volume of 125 liters. The digesters are equipped with an inlet point and an outlet point, as well as a sampling point at the middle of the digester. After getting the hydrolysis results, and once the reactors are stable, the two reactors will thus be combined such that the substrates fed onto the hydrolysis reactor after retention time of about 4 days proceeds on to the next reactor, which is the methanogenic reactor for gas production, where it will have a retention time of 25 days. In case of very low pH value,